Live, this is 24-Hour News 8.
Now at 6 o'clock, Hurricane Sandy. It is big, it's powerful, it's dangerous, and it's about to barrel right into the East Coast.
Its winds are already doing damage like this in New York City, toppling a huge crane there. And like this all along our eastern shores, ripping piers to shreds like they're made of popsicle sticks.
Sandy is literally putting the Atlantic in Atlantic City, New Jersey tonight, flooding that resort and casino town with a foot of ocean water, and it's only going to get worse. And if you head inland into the mountains, look at this. Snow is falling. Portions of North Carolina are in the middle of a blizzard.
Sandy's wrath is being felt even here. Lake Michigan is rough, and wind gusts are going to continue to strengthen out there.
Tonight, we're tracking this storm from the coast to the Great Lakes as the eye of the superstorm gets ready to hit the East Coast. Good evening, everyone. I'm Brian Sterling.
And I'm Susan Shaw. The experience of Storm Team 8 is here to walk us through what's going to happen. We begin with Chief Meteorologist Bill Steffen tonight.
Well, Sue, the storm is coming onshore as we speak in New Jersey, producing a lot of flooding to the north of where the eye is coming onshore. Let's go back to Storm Track Live. It's a satellite picture, and it's easy to kind of pick out right in here as to where the center of the storm is. The real storm surge has occurred from New Jersey up through New York, Long Island, and up into Massachusetts. Some places reporting waves up to 30 feet crashing in, and storm surge is up to 9 feet, which means the level of the ocean is up about 9 feet higher than it normally would be. This occurring right at the time of the full moon as well. Here's a look at the center of the storm as it comes on in. You can see the bands of heavier rain already into eastern Ohio, and that is tracking towards us. So if we come in a little bit closer toward our area right here, we'll see if we can stop her here for just a second and put a track on the leading edge of the more significant rain as it comes to the west. Kind of unusual to see it move in that direction. 7 hours to Lansing, about 10 hours to Grand Rapids. So bottom line is you're going to be kind of on the dry side here this evening, but we're going to be seeing a chance for some showers or mixed precipitation late tonight.
Let's bring in Kyle Underwood right now to walk us through how Sandy will impact us here in Michigan.
Yeah, we're going to feel the effects locally, but compared to what we're dealing with on the East Coast, this should be pretty easy to get through. I want to show you sustained wind speeds. Now, keep in mind, when we talk about sustained, it's important to draw the distinction between this and peak gusts, which will be much higher than these numbers. Let's put this into motion. So this is this evening. Watch these numbers grow as we head into tomorrow. And our latest computer model data has sustained winds around 30 miles per hour, and gusts could approach 50. Take a look at the lakeshore zones here. Parts of Oceana County, Little Sauble Point, all the way down south of South Haven, we could see 30 to 35 mile per hour sustained winds. And then once we get into the evening, the winds finally come down. Now, winds are definitely going to be stronger at the lakeshore. I believe this puts it in perspective for us. The top line here is Michigan City down at the southern tip of Lake Michigan. Here's Grand Rapids. You can see the difference in sustained winds. We're talking about 40 plus for sustained winds with gusts perhaps approaching 60 at the southern tip of Lake Michigan. Not quite that breezy here across west the interior parts of West Michigan, but strong winds, no doubt about that.
All right, Kyle, thank you. The surf is up in St. Joseph. Look at this, waves crashing against the break wall, stretching out into Lake Michigan, and those waves are continuing to grow tonight. Meteorologist Matt Kirkwood's live a little further north along Lake Michigan and Holland tonight. Matt?
Hey, Brian. Yeah, out here right now, if you really want to see the power of Mother Nature come out to the lakeshore, just don't go on the breakwaters. Way too risky. I was just talking to my photographer, Ron Swanson. We've noticed just in the past hour and a half, the winds have really picked up dramatically along the lakeshore. And look what it's doing right now. Right now, I'd say about 4 to 7 foot waves crashing up against the breakwater here in the Holland area. And of course, as you go farther south along the lakeshore, waves are going to get a little higher than this. So I just checked out the buoy and right around central southern Lake Michigan, they're reporting waves about 11 feet. But you have to keep in mind the wind is going to continue to increase right on through the overnight period and likely peaking into midday Tuesday. Now, the forecast anywhere from Holland to South Haven, we're expecting wave heights along the lakeshore to build 14 to 16 feet. And if you're around Benton Harbor or south of South Haven, we could see waves 16 to 20 feet. Also want to point out that cloud shield off in the distance, that is the western periphery of the storm, which is over 650 miles away from us. And we are within the scope of the wind. I find that just absolutely amazing. Now we're looking at over south central Lake Michigan waves possibly getting up to 30 feet. That's amazing too, but it still pales in comparison of some of the forecasts off in New Jersey and New York, where they're expecting waves 35 to 46 feet. Just got an email from Craig James. He said some of the observations of the wind as Sandy has come on shore. Croton in Connecticut, 76 mile an hour wind. JFK in New York, 66. And Plum Island, New York, an 84 mile an hour wind gust. Very impressive. And again, fortunately this time of year, we don't have to worry about recreational boaters or swimmers. That's good news.
No, but Matt, I noticed that a lot of people were still kind of walking out along that pier, maybe not going all the way out on the jetty, but they were close enough to the water. Have there been a lot of people going out there today?
Yeah, there's actually the parking lot starting to fill up quite a bit. First couple rows, there's cars out here, and you know, it's kind of cool to watch. Fortunately, though, you can't see it real well, but if you're familiar with Holland Breakwater, it kind of goes out towards the north and heads due west. People are kind of stopping right at the where it starts to kink westward. Fortunately, they have the wherewithal, the smarts, not to go any further than that. I talked with a gentleman just a moment ago. He said, yeah, earlier in the day, he was able to go all the way out, but he said, no way would I risk going out there right now. So don't even think about it, folks.
All right, Matt Kirkwood live for us in Holland tonight. Matt, thanks.
Waves are incredible out there. Because of the waves, a Lake Express ferry is canceling trips between Muskegon and Milwaukee for both today and tomorrow. No surprise there. Air travel around the nation is a mess, including at Ford Airport in Kent County. If you plan to fly somewhere over the next few days, you are going to want to continually check your flight status. We have a link to the flight board at Ford Airport. That is at woodtv.com.
And we will continue to track Sandy throughout the night. NBC Nightly News, in fact, live team coverage for you on a special one-hour edition of Nightly. We'll have live coverage for you tonight at 10 and 11, and tomorrow morning again on Daybreak, starting at 4:30.